The Battle of Vienna, German, Schlachtkallenberg, Polish, Bitwa pod Wiednym Orodz Swedenska, Turkish, I conceive an accusatmas, is a battle that took place on 11 and the 12th of September 1683 after Vienna had been besieged by the Ottoman Empire for 2 months. It was a battle of the Holy Roman Empire in league with the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, Holy League, versus the Muslim Ottoman Empire and chiefdoms of the Ottoman Empire, and took place at the Kahlenberg Mountain near Vienna. The battle marked the beginning of the political hegemony of the Habsburg dynasty in the Holy Roman Empire and Central Europe. The battle was won by the combined forces of the Holy Roman Empire and the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, the latter being represented only by the forces of the Crown of the Kingdom of Poland. The march of the Lithuanian army was delayed, as a result they arrived in Vienna after it was relieved. The Viennese garrison was led by Ernst Rudiger Graf von Stahremberg, an Austrian subject of Leopold I, Holy Roman Emperor. The overall command was held by the commander of the Polish forces, the King of Poland, Jan III Sobieski. The alliance fought the army of the Ottoman Empire and those of Ottoman fiefdoms commanded by Grand Vizier Mirza von Lukara Mustafa Pasha. The siege itself began on 14 July 1683, by the Ottoman Empire army of approximately 90,000 to 300,000 men. The besieging force was composed of 60 orders of Janissaries, 12,000 men paper strength, with an observation army of c.70,000 men watching the countryside. The decisive battle took place on 12 September, after the United Relief Army of approximately 84,000 men had arrived. It has been suggested by some historians that the battle marked the turning point in the Ottoman-Habsburg Wars, the 300-year struggle between the Holy Roman Empire and the Ottoman Empire. Indeed, over the 16 years following the battle, the Habsburgs of Austria gradually occupied and dominated southern Hungary and Transylvania, which had been largely cleared of the Ottoman forces. However, post-Orientalist historiographies shed light on the fact that the Ottoman Empire did remain strong and imposing in the Balkan despite some administrative, economic and military turmoils up until the late 18th century. Much of the Holy League's gains would be recaptured by the Ottomans, such as the Moru and Azov, while the Balkan territories would fall back in parts to the Ottoman Empire by the Treaty of Passerowitz. The capture of the city of Vienna had long been a strategic aspiration of the Ottoman Empire, due to its interlocking control over Danubian, Black Sea to Western Europe, Southern Europe, and the overland, Eastern Mediterranean to Germany, trade routes. During the years preceding the latter siege, the former had taken place in 1529, under the auspices of grand viziers from the influential Korprulu family. The Ottoman Empire undertook extensive logistical preparations, including the repair and establishment of roads and bridges leading into the Holy Roman Empire and its logistical centers, as well as the forwarding of ammunition, cannon and other resources from all over the Ottoman Empire to these centers and into the Balkans. Since 1679, the plague had been raging in Vienna. On the political front, the Ottoman Empire had been providing military assistance to the Hungarians and to non-Catholic minorities in Habsburg-occupied portions of Hungary. There, in the years preceding the siege, widespread unrest had become open rebellion against Leopold I's pursuit of counter-reformation principles and his desire to crush Protestantism. In 1681, Protestants and other anti-Habsburg Kirk forces, led by Imad Okali, were reinforced with a significant force from the Ottomans, who recognized Thokoli as king of Upper Hungary, the eastern part of today's Slovakia and parts of today's northeastern Hungary, which he had earlier taken by force of arms from the Habsburgs. This support went so far as explicitly to promise the Kingdom of Vienna to the Hungarians if it fell into Ottoman hands. 129 Yet before the siege, a state of peace had existed for 20 years between the Holy Roman Empire and the Ottoman Empire as a result of the Peace of Vazva. In 1681 and 1682, clashes between the forces of Imad Okali and the Holy Roman Empire, of which the border was then northern Hungary, intensified, and the incursions of Habsburg forces into central Hungary provided the crucial argument of Grand Vizier Kara Mustafa Pasha in convincing the Sultan, Mehmet IV and his Divan, to allow the movement of the Ottoman army. Mehmet IV authorized Kara Mustafa Pasha to operate as far as Gjor. The name during the Ottoman period was Yankal, German Rab, and Komrom, Turkish Komoran, German Komorn, castles, both in northwestern Hungary, and to besiege them. The Ottoman army was mobilized on the 21st of January 1682, and war was declared on the 6th of August 1682. The logistics of the time meant that it would have been risky or impossible to launch an invasion in August or September 1682. A three-month campaign would have gotten the Ottomans to Vienna just as winter set in. However, this 15-month gap between mobilization and the launch of a full-scale invasion allowed ample time for Vienna to prepare its defense and for Leopold to assemble troops from the Holy Roman Empire and set up an alliance with Poland, Venice and Pope Innocent XI. Undoubtedly, this contributed to the failure of the Ottoman campaign. The decisive alliance of the Holy Roman Empire with Poland was concluded in the 1683 Treaty of Warsaw, in which Leopold promised support to Sobieski if the Ottomans attacked Krakow. In return, the Polish army would come to the relief of Vienna if it were attacked. On the 31st of March 1683, another declaration, sent by Grand Vizier Mirza von Lukara Mustafa Pasha on behalf of Mehmet IV, arrived at the imperial court in Vienna. On the next day, the forward march of Ottoman army elements began from Edirne in Thrace. The Turkish troops reached Belgrade by early 31 March, were joined by a Transylvanian army under Prince Mihaly Apafi and a Hungarian force under a Mirandus called Okali, laid siege to Gjor, and the remaining army of 150,000 moved toward the city of Vienna. About 40,000 Crimean Tatar troops arrived 40 kilometers east of Vienna on 7 July, twice as many as the imperial troops in the area. Emperor Leopold flees Vienna for Passau with his court and 60,000 Viennese, while Charles V, Duke of Lorraine, withdraws his force of 20,000 towards Linz. The main Turkish army arrives to Vienna on 14 July. Now only defended by Count Ernst underscore Rudiarisis Diger underscore von underscore Star Emberg's 15,000 men. The King of Poland Jan III Sobieski prepared a relief expedition to Vienna during the summer of 1683, so honoring his obligations to the treaty. He went so far as to leave his own nation virtually undefended when departing from Krakow on 15 August. Sobieski covered this with a stern warning to Imre Okali, the leader of Hungary, whom he threatened with destruction if he tried to take advantage of the situation, which Thokoli in fact attempted. Jan Kazimierz Sapa the Younger delayed the march of the Lithuanian army, devastating the Hungarian highlands, now Slovakia, instead, and arrived in Vienna only after it had been relieved. Immediately tensions rose between Poland and the various German states, above all Austria, over the relief of the city. Payment of troops' wages and supplies while marching was predominant among these. Sobieski demanded that he should not have to pay for his march to Vienna, since it was by his efforts that the city had been saved, nor could the Viennese neglect the other German troops who had marched. The Habsburg leadership hurriedly found as much money as possible to pay for these and arranged deals with the Polish to limit their costs. The main Ottoman army finally laid siege to Vienna on 14 July. On the same day, Kara Mustafa sent the traditional demand for surrender to the city. Ernst Rudiger Graf von Starhemberg, leader of the remaining 15,000 troops and 8,700 volunteers with 370 cannons, refused to capitulate. Only days before, he had received news of the mass slaughter at Perchtoldsdorf, a town south of Vienna where the citizens had handed over the keys of the city after having been given a similar choice. Siege operations started on 17 July. The Viennese had demolished many of the houses around the city walls and cleared the debris, leaving an empty plain that would expose the Ottomans to defensive fire if they tried to rush the city. Kara Mustafa Pasha solved that problem by ordering his forces to dig long lines of trenches directly toward the city, to help protect them from the defenders as they advanced steadily toward the city. Sabahs of the Ottoman Empire. At Vienna, the Ottomans had 130 field guns and 19 medium-caliber cannons, insufficient in the face of the defenders' 370 cannons. The fortifications of Vienna were very strong and up to date, and the Ottomans had to find a more effective use for their gunpowder. Mining tunnels were dug under the massive city walls to blow them up with substantial quantities of black powder. The absence of prompt action by the Ottomans at this point, combined with the delay in advancing their army after declaring war, eventually allowed a Polish relief force to arrive in September. Historians have speculated that Kara Mustafa wanted to take the city intact with its riches, and that he declined an all-out attack, not wishing to activate the right of plunder which would accompany an assault. The Ottoman siege cut virtually every means of food supply into Vienna, and the garrison and civilian volunteers suffered extreme hardships. Fatigue became such a problem that Graf Ernst Trudiger von Stauffenberg ordered any soldier found asleep on watch to be shot. Increasingly desperate, the forces holding Vienna were on their last legs when in August, imperial forces under Charles V, Duke of Lorraine defeated Imhotep Oekeli of Hungary at Bismarck, 5 kilometers northwest of Vienna. On 6 September the Poles under Jan III Sobieski crossed the Danube 30 kilometers northwest of Vienna at Tulln, to unite with the imperial troops and the additional forces from Saxony, Bavaria, Baden, Franconia and Swabia. Louis XIV of France declined to help his Habsburg rival, having just annexed Alsace, the result of an alliance of John III Sobieski and the Emperor Leopold. The first was to add the Polish hussars to the already existing Allied army. The command of the forces of European allies was entrusted to the Polish king, who had under his command 70,000 soldiers facing a Turkish army of 150,000. The remarkable aptitude as commander and the courage of John III Sobieski were already known in Europe. After the relief of Vienna, Pope the Bl. Innocent XI extended to the Universal Church the Marian Feast of 12 September, the decisive day in the battle. The Pope also upgraded the papal coat of arms by adding the Polish crown white eagle. After the victory in the Battle of Vienna, the Polish king was also granted by the Pope the title of Defender of the Faith. Defensa Fide. During early September, the experienced 5,000 Ottoman sappers had repeatedly blown up large portions of the walls between the Burg Bastion, the Lobel Bastion and the Burg Ravelin, creating gaps of about 12 meters in width. The Viennese tried to counter this by digging their own tunnels to intercept the depositing of large amounts of gunpowder in subterranean caverns. The Ottomans finally managed to occupy the Burg Ravelin and the low wall in that area on 8 September. Anticipating a breach in the city walls, the remaining Viennese prepared to fight in the inner city. Staging the Battle Sobieski at Vienna by Julius's Cossack. The relief of Vienna on the 12th of September 1683. The relief army had to act quickly to save the city and so prevent another long siege. Despite the binational composition of the army and the short space of only 6 days, an effective leadership structure was established, centered on the King of Poland and his heavy cavalry, Polish hussars. The Holy League settled the issues of payment by using all available funds from the government, loans from several wealthy bankers and noblemen and large sums of money from the Pope. Also, the Habsburgs and Poles agreed that the Polish government would pay for its own troops while still in Poland, but would be paid for by the Emperor once they had crossed into imperial territory. However, the Emperor had to recognize Sobieski's claim to first rights of plunder in the event of a victory. Kara Mustafa Pasha, on the other hand, was less effective, despite having had months to organize his forces, to ensure their motivation and loyalty, and to prepare for the expected relief army attack. He had entrusted defense of the rear to the Khan of Crimea and his cavalry force, which numbered about 30 to 40,000. There are serious questions as to how far the Tatar forces participated in the final battle before Vienna. Their Khan refused to attack the Polish relief force as it crossed the Danube on pontoon bridges and refusing to attack them as they emerged from the Wienerwald. Polish hussars armor, dating to the first half of the 17th century, Polish Army Museum, Warsaw. Also, the Ottomans could not rely on their Wallachian and Moldavian allies. George Ducas, Prince of Moldavia, was captured while Serban Cantacuzino's forces, Prince of Wallachia, joined the retreat after Sobieski's cavalry charge. On the arrival of the Confederated troops on the Kahlenberg above Vienna, they signaled their arrival with bonfires. In the early morning hours of 12 September, before the battle, A mass was celebrated for the King of Poland and his nobles. Battle. The battle started before all units were fully deployed. At 4 a.m. the Ottomans attacked, seeking to interfere with the deployment of the Holy League troops. Charles of Lorraine moved forward with the Imperial Army on the left, with the other Holy Roman Imperial forces in the center. Mustafa Pasha launched a counterattack with most of his force, that held back some of the elite Janissary and Sipahi units for a simultaneous assault on the city. The Ottoman commanders had intended to take Vienna before Sobieski arrived, but time ran out. Their sappers had prepared another large and final detonation under the low bell bastui to breach the walls. In total, 10 mines were set to explode, but they were located and disarmed. At that moment, a large battle was going on above the subterranean battlefield as the Polish infantry launched a massive assault on the Ottoman right flank. Instead of focusing on the battle with the relief army, the Ottomans continued their efforts to force their way into the city. At one point during the battle, Kara Mustafa personally ordered the execution of 30,000 Christian hostages. After 12 hours of fighting, the Poles held the high ground on the right. On the flanks, it is recorded that the Polish cavalry slowly emerged from the forest to the cheers of the onlooking infantry who had been anticipating their arrival. The Holy League cavalry waited on the hills and watched the infantry battle for the whole day. At about 5 p.m., the Polish king ordered the cavalry attack in four groups, one from the Holy Roman Empire and three Polish. 18,000 horsemen charged down the hills, the largest cavalry charge in history. Jan 3 Sobieski led the charge at the head of 3,000 Polish heavy lancers, the famed winged hussars. The Lipka Tatars who fought on the Polish side wore a sprig of straw in their helmets to distinguish themselves from the Tatars fighting on the Ottoman side. The charge broke the lines of the Ottomans, who were exhausted from the long struggle on two fronts. The cavalry headed straight for the Ottoman camps and Kara Mustafa's headquarters, while the remaining Viennese garrison sallied out of its defenses to join in the assault. A cloud causes the crescent moon to fade from view, an ominous omen for the Turks. The Ottoman troops were tired and dispirited following the failure of both the attempted sapping and the assault on the city by brute force. The arrival of the cavalry turned the tide of battle against them, sending them into retreat to the south and east by nightfall. In less than 3 hours after the cavalry attack, the Christian forces had won the battle and saved Vienna. Afterwards, Sobieski paraphrased Julius Caesar's famous quotation, Veni, Vidi, Vici, by saying Veni, Vidi, Deus Visit, I came, I saw, God conquered. Return from Vienna by Joseph Brandt, Polish army returning with loot of the Ottoman forces. Aftermath. The Ottomans lost at least 20,000 men during the siege and up to 40,000 during the battle with Sobieski's forces. Ottoman accounts quote a lower figure due to their not counting the fallen of Ottoman vassal, allied states and other Muslim volunteers. The loot that fell into the hands of the Holy League troops and the Viennese was as huge as their relief, as King John Sobieski vividly described in a letter to his wife a few days after the battle. Ours are treasures unheard of. Tents, sheep, cattle and no small number of camels. It is victory as nobody ever knew before, the enemy now completely ruined, everything lost for them. They must run for their sheer lives. General Starhemberg hugged and kissed me and called me his savior. Starhemberg immediately ordered the repair of Vienna's severely damaged fortifications to guard against a possible Ottoman counter-strike. However, this proved unnecessary. Soon the Ottomans had disposed of their defeated commander. On the 25th of December 1683, Kara Mustafa Pasha was executed in Belgrade, in the approved manner, by strangulation with a silk rope pulled by several men on each end, by order of the commander of the Janissaries. Despite the victory of the Christian allies, there was still some tension between the various commanders and their armies. For example, Sobieski demanded that the Polish troops be allowed to have first choice of the spoils of the Turkish camp, since he believed it was his efforts entirely that saved Vienna. The German and Austrian troops were left with much smaller portions of the loot. Also, the Protestant Germans, specifically the Saxons, who had arrived to relieve the city, were apparently subjected to verbal abuse by the Catholic populace of the Viennese countryside. The Saxons left the battle immediately, without partaking in the sharing of spoils and refusing to continue pursuit. Sobieski went on to liberate Grau and northwestern Hungary after the Battle of Parkeny, but dysentery halted his pursuit of the Turks. Charles V took Belgrade and the most of Serbia in 1686, and established Habsburg control over southern Hungary and most of Transylvania in 1687. Significance: the victory at Vienna set the stage for Prince Eugene of Savoy's reconquering of Hungary and, temporarily, some of the Balkan lands. Within the following years, the Ottomans fought on for another 16 years, losing control of Hungary and Transylvania in the process before finally giving up. The Holy Roman Empire signed the Treaty of Karlowitz with the Ottoman Empire in 1699. The battle marked the historic end of the expansion of the Ottoman Empire into Europe. In honor of Sobieski, the Austrians erected a church atop the Kahlenberg Hill north of Vienna. The train route from Vienna to Warsaw is also named in Sobieski's honor. The constellation Scutum Sobieski, Sobieski's shield, was named to commemorate the battle. Because Sobieski had entrusted his kingdom to the protection of the Blessed Virgin, Our Lady of Czestochowa, before the battle, Pope Innocent XI commemorated his victory by extending the feast of the Holy Name of Mary, which until then had been celebrated solely in Spain and the Kingdom of Naples, to the Universal Church. It is celebrated on 12 September. Cultural legacy, astronomical legacy. After the Battle of Vienna, the newly identified constellation Scutum, Latin for shield, was originally named Scutum Sobisinum by the astronomer Johannes Hevelius, in honor of Jan III Sobieski. While there are some few stars named after non-astronomers, this is the only constellation that was originally named after a real non-astronomer who was still alive when the constellation was named, and the name of which is still in use. Three other constellations, satisfying the same requirements, never gained enough popularity to last. Religious significance: the Feast of the Holy Name of Mary is celebrated on 12 September in the liturgical calendar of the Catholic Church in commemoration of the victory in this battle of Christian Europe over the Muslim forces of the Ottoman Empire. Before the battle, King Jan had placed his troops under the protection of the Blessed Virgin Mary. After the battle, Pope Innocent XI, wishing to honor Mary, extended the feast to the entire church. Musical legacy: the Ottomans were pushed away from Vienna, the military bands left their instruments on the field of battle, and that is how the Holy Roman Empire, and thus the other Western countries, acquired cymbals and the timpani. The Austrian composer Johann Joseph Fuchs memorialized the battle in his Partita Turcaria, which bore the subtitle, Musical Portrait of the Siege of Vienna by the Turks in 1683 inches. It is said that the victors found in the left luggage of the Ottomans the Taragato, a double reed woodwind instrument that was to become the Hungarian national symbol for freedom after Rákóczi's defeat against the Ottomans in 1711. Culinary legends: several culinary legends are related to the Battle of Vienna. One legend is that the croissant was invented in Vienna, either in 1683 or during the earlier siege. In 1529, to celebrate the defeat of the Ottoman attack on the city, with the shape referring to the crescents on the Ottoman flags. This version of the origin of the croissant is supported by the fact that croissants in French are a variant of Vienna iserie, and by the French popular belief that Vienna-born Marie Antoinette introduced the pastry to France in 1770. Another legend from Vienna has the first bagel as being a gift to King Jan Sobieski to commemorate the king's victory over the Ottomans. It was fashioned in the form of a stirrup, to commemorate the victorious charge by the Polish cavalry. The veracity of this legend is uncertain, as there is a reference in 1610 to a bread with a similar sounding name, which may or may not have been the bagel. After the battle, the Viennese discovered many bags of coffee in the abandoned Ottoman encampment. Using this captured stock, Franciszek Jerzy Kolczyński opened the third coffee house in Europe and the first in Vienna. There is no contemporary historical source connecting Marco Daviano, the Capuchin friar and confidant of Leopold I, Holy Roman Emperor, with the invention of cappuccinos. On 12 September, After the United Relief Army of approximately 84,000 men had arrived, it has been suggested by some historians that the battle marked the turning point in the Ottoman-Habsburg Wars, the 300-year struggle between the Holy Roman Empire and the Ottoman Empire. Indeed, over the 16 years following the battle, the Habsburgs of Austria gradually occupied and dominated southern Hungary and Transylvania, which had been largely cleared of the Ottoman forces. However, post-Orientalist historiographies shed light on the fact that the Ottoman Empire did remain strong and imposing in the Balkan despite some administrative, economic and military turmoils up until the late 18th century. Much of the Holy League's gains would be recaptured by the Ottomans, such as the Mora and Azov, while the Balkan territories would fall back in Pjing in Vienna. On the political front, the Ottoman Empire had been providing military assistance to the Hungarians and to non-Catholic minorities in Habsburg-occupied portions of Hungary. There, in the years preceding the siege, widespread unrest had become open rebellion against Leopold's pursuit of Counter-Reformation principles and his desire to crush Protestantism. In 1681, Protestants and other anti-Habsburg Kirk forces, led by Imad Okali, were reinforced with a significant force from the Ottomans, who recognized Thokoli as king of Upper Hungary, the eastern part of today's Slovakia and parts of today's northeastern Hungary, which he had earlier taken by force of arms from the Habsburgs. This support went so far as explicitly to promise the Kingdom of Vienna to the Hungarians if it fell into Ottoman hands. Colon army was delayed. As a result, they arrived in Vienna after it was relieved. The Viennese garrison was led by Ernst Rudiger Graf von Stahremberg, an Austrian subject of Leopold I, Holy Roman Emperor. The overall command was held by the commander of the Polish forces, the King of Poland, Jan III Sobieski. The alliance fought the army of the Ottoman Empire and those of Ottoman fiefdoms commanded by Grand Vizier Mirza von Lukara Mustafa Pasha. The siege itself began on 14 July 1683. By the Ottoman Empire army of approximately 90,000 to 300,000 men. The besieging force was composed of 60 orders of Janissaries, 12,000 men paper strength, with an observation army of c.70,000 men watching the countryside. The decisive battle took place hearts to the Ottoman Empire by the Treaty of Passerowitz. The capture of the city of Vienna had long been a strategic aspiration of the Ottoman Empire, due to its interlocking control over Danubian, Black Sea to Western Europe, Southern Europe, and the overland, Eastern Mediterranean to Germany, trade routes. During the years preceding the latter siege, the former had taken place in 1529, under the auspices of grand viziers from the influential Korprulu family. The Ottoman Empire undertook extensive logistical preparations, including the repair and establishment of roads and bridges leading into the Holy Roman Empire and its logistical centers, as well as the forwarding of ammunition, cannon and other resources from all over the Ottoman Empire to these centers and into the Balkans. Since 1679 the plague had been raged. The Battle of Vienna, German, Schlachtam Kahlenberg, Polish, Bitwa pod Wiedniem Orodz Swedenska, Turkish, I conceive an accusatmas, is a battle that took place on 11 and the 12th of September 1683 after Vienna had been besieged by the Ottoman Empire for 2 months. It was a battle of the Holy Roman Empire in league with the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, Holy League, versus the Muslim Ottoman Empire and chiefdoms of the Ottoman Empire, and took place at the Kahlenberg Mountain near Vienna. The battle marked the beginning of the political hegemony of the Habsburg dynasty in the Holy Roman Empire and Central Europe. The battle was won by the combined forces of the Holy Roman Empire and the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, the latter being represented only by the forces of the Crown of the Kingdom of Poland. The March of the Lithuanian